Next, we have this problem naman. Now, itong problem na to, na-discuss ko na to sa YouTube, but in Bisaya kasi. So, para sa viewers natin from Manila, I will just discuss this again na Tagalog na. For a while, ah. Break lang muna tayo. Saglit. So, dito sa next problem natin, we have a problem involving frame analysis. So, determine all forces daw acting on member ACD of this frame. The diameter of the pulley at D is 8 inches. Yan. Pag may dalawang gitling, inches yan. Pag isa lang, yan yung feet. And then, the weight of the body daw is 500 pounds. Ito. What is the resultant force at D, C, and A? So, yan yung mga questions natin. So, what we can do first is analyze natin yung pulley at D. So, FBD ng pulley. Yan. Merong circle and then W is again 500 pounds. And then meron tayong connected yan siya. Naka-incline siya dito. So meron ganyan. And then this is 500 pounds pa rin. Kasi along the same line lang sila. So, ano yung inclination niya? Diba, we can draw a triangle dito. Ito na lang. Yan. We can draw a triangle. This one. And then, yung inclination pala nito is 12 inches. Yan. And then, ano na lang. Wait lang. Ito pala. Yan. Parallel lang kasi yung dalawa. This one and this one. Parallel. So, 12 inches to. Up to here. This is also 12. So, the same yung legs. Pwede kang mag arctangent of 12 over 12. But, mas mabuti pag alam mo na kung the same yung value ng legs, that's a 45 degree triangle. So, this is 45 degrees pala. Yan. So, essentially, pwede natin kunin yung reactions dito sa pin. Yan. And then, just remember na if you will move to another member, yung internal force must change directions. So, yung masosolve natin dito, upward na reaction, but for frame ECD na, it will now be downward. Makikita nyo lang yan. So, sabihin natin, we have this force, dy, saka dx. Yan. So, summation of forces along y, equate na lang natin yung magkaiba yung directions. Ito lang yung upward, yung dalawa downward, but we have to take the vertical component of this pa. So, dy is 500 plus 500 sine 45. Yan. And then, summation of forces a long x. We have dx equals 500 cos 45. So, ano yan? Check natin. This is 853.55. Naka pounds. And then 500 cos 45 is 353. Yan. So, alam na natin yung reactions dito. So, pwede na natin yan siyang i-transmit sa ACD. But again, mag-change na yung directions. But, wala kasing, hindi kasi natin alam yung reaction sa pin at C. So, pwede natin yan kunin. So, we can consider this member. Yan, member BC. So, pag i-draw natin yung FBD, we have this one, and then, this is 16 inches. And then, merong pin dyan, so, we have upward and horizontal reactions. Yan. And then, also here. Kasi merong pin. Meron ding CY saka CX. Now, aside from the reactions, we also need the tensile force, which is this one. Now, alam natin na this is along the same rope. So, 500 pounds lang din yung tension dyan. But, naka-incline siya. So, we have this, and then naka-incline. Ibahin na lang natin yung color. Yan, naka-incline. This is 500 pounds. Now, the inclination is still 45 degrees. Kasi again, this line is parallel to this. So, 45 degrees. Yan. So, we can get the vertical reaction at B or yung C na lang. CY na lang yung kukunin natin kasi yan lang yung kailangan natin. So, we can sum up moments about B. So, we have CY minus CY multiplied by 16. Yan. And then, the horizontal component of this force tatama lang sa point B, so magiging 0 lang. But the vertical component, it has a moment arm of this value, which is hindi pa natin alam. And then it will also cause a counterclockwise rotation, so 500 sine 45, i-component muna natin, and then multiplied by a certain distance. So, paano yan kukunin? We essentially want itong distance na to. Yan. Ano yan siya? Paano yan kukunin? So, ito yung pwede natin gawin. Diba, parallel yung dalawang lines. Bala, ito. Yan, diba, ito man yung distance na kailangan natin. Yan. So, we can actually extend this line. Dyan. Yan yung termination point. And then, let's draw a line. Wait lang. We'll draw a line na parallel to this. So, copy ko na lang. Yan. And then, diba, pwede kong extend ito. So, magmi-meet sila at a common point. So, if this is x, yan, then this is also x. Now, yung tanong is, paano kukunin yung value ng x? Check muna natin yung given. Diba, we are given that the diameter of the pulley is 8 inches. So, yung radius pala, dito na lang, diameter is 8 inches, so the radius is 4 inches. Yan. Now, I hope you would agree na this is the radius. Yan. So, if this is the radius from the center to the outer point of the circle, this is 4 inches pala. Yan. And then, ano pa yung pwede natin gawin? Diba, we can get the angles. So, this is a right triangle, yan. Bakit right? Kasi, from the center, drawn to a point, tangent to the circle, always perpendicular yung angle. So, this is 4 inches. And then, analyze muna natin yung angle natin. Yan. So, diba, this is with respect sa horizontal. Yan. 45 degrees. So, ito pala, with respect sa horizontal line, this is 45 degrees. Yan. So, if this is 45 degrees, makukuha na natin yung value ng x. Kasi yung x, yan yung hypotenuse ng triangle na to. Yan. So, we can use, meron tayong hypotenuse, meron tayong opposite side. So, we can use opposite over hypotenuse, sine theta. So, sine of 45 degrees equals opposite ng 45 is 4. Yan. And then divided by x. So x is 4 divided by sine 45, which is 4 square root of 2. This is inches. Yan. So, now na alam na natin yung x, we can now take moments about B. So, the moment about B is parang 16 minus x. And this is x. Which is, ano nga yun? 4 square root of 2. Yan. So, 16 pala minus 4 square root of 2. We have 500 sine 45. Then 16 minus 4 square root of 2. We have minus 228.55. And this is pounds. Now, negative, ibig sabihin, mali pala yung assumption natin. So CY must be downward. Yan. But again, this is for member BC. Once we move to another member, let's say member ACD, then we have to change the directions of this. Yan. So this is downward. So sa kabilang side pala, dapat ano na siya? Upward. So dito naman tayo sa member ACD. Yan. So we have point A. May pin dyan. So although ruler yung external reaction dyan, I mean external support, we still have pin reactions dito. So sabihin natin AY, ito naman AX, and then at this point yan, we have CX saka CY. So CX is directed to the left sa member BC. So it must now act to the right para dito. So this is CX. Yan. Now, pwede nating palitan yung arrow nito. Since alam natin na it must act downward, change na lang natin. Yan, gawin natin downward. So sa kabilang member, it must now act upward na. So this is CY. And the new forces from the pulley must also act in a different direction. So itong DY is upward. So now it will be directed downward na. So DY is 853.55. And DX naman, this is acting to the right. So dito, dapat to the left na. And this is 353. Yung distances naman, from A to C, 16 inches. And this is 12. And then ito naman, 12 saka 16. Yan. So masosolve na natin yung isa dito, yung resultant force at D. Kasi yung kailangan lang natin are the forces sa pulley. So this is square root of dx squared plus dy squared. So square root of 853.55 plus 353.55 squared. Yan. So we have 923.88. So this is letter C. Yan. And then for the resultant force at C naman, kailangan pa nating ma-solve yung CX. So to solve CX, we can take moments about A. So summation of moments about A. Alam natin si CY. This is 228.55. Yan. And so we have CX multiplied by 16 going to A, yan, perpendicular distance, minus CY, 228.55, multiplied by 16 inches. I mean, not 16. Ito pala na 16. CY multiplied by 16. And then we have 853.55. It will cause a clockwise rotation, so plus. Multiplied by 12 plus 16, so 28. And then minus 353.55. Ito. Multiplied by 12 plus 16, so 28. So set to 0, we can solve CX. 16x minus 228.55 times 16 plus 853.55 times 28 minus 353.55 multiplied by 28. Yan. So, solve natin. We have 646.45. Negative yun. So, this is pounds. Yan. So, by the way pala, negative yan. So, mali pala yung assumption natin. So, instead of going to the right, CX pala is going to the left. Yan. But again, we can retain the same direction ng arrow, but just take into account the sign kung magsosolve ka na ng forces horizontal. So, meron na tayong CX saka CY. So, masasolve na din natin yung second question. Resultant force at C. So, square root of CX squared plus CY squared. Yan. So, again, we have ito, 228.55. Square natin, and then we also have 646.45. Square din natin. So, ito pala. Letter B, 685.662. Yan. And then for the last question naman, ano daw yung resultant force at A? So, ito, kailangan muna natin kunin yung AY saka AX. But madali lang yung AX. Kasi alam na natin yung CX. So we can sum up forces. Vertical na lang muna. So, AY plus 228.55 minus 853.55 set to 0. AY pala is 853.55 minus 228. So, 625. And then, to get AX naman, we can sum up forces horizontal. So, we have AX plus CX according to the figure. Again, although we know na to the left siya, just take into account the signs. And then minus 353.55. Yan. So, AX minus 646.45 kasa minus yung sign dyan plus 353.55. So, AX is 646.45 minus 353.55. Tama ba? Check ko na. AX. Ito. To the left. Ay, sorry. Minus pala to. Yan. So, plus dapat to. So, 1,000. So, meron na tayong AX saka AY. Yung dalawa. So, the reaction at A pala is 1,000 squared plus 625 squared. So, magiging 1179.25. Yan. So, ito pala. Letter C. Again, this was 685.66. Yan. So, medyo madali lang yung problem. Yung mahirap lang dito is yung pagkuha ng X. Yan. Yan.